All the headlines were ACORN's dead, ACORN's gone away. That was a strategic move, and they did it on election day because they knew that the Republicans were going to take back the House, and they wanted to be in a position to where when investigations started rolling around, they could say, why are you beating a dead horse? ACORN is no longer around. The threat is gone. You won. But the fact of the matter was, since before the embezzlement scandal was exposed in 2008, ACORN was getting its ducks in order because it knew that it might not be able to survive the scandal. The first thing they did was get rid of Wade Rathke. But he didn't go far. He's still running ACORN International, or just called in the United States Community Organizations International. And they did that because they wanted to protect Obama. And they knew that leading into the 2008 elections, it would be easier if they said, we got rid of Rathke, everything's fine, ACORN is taking care of it internally. They were hoping people would kind of look the other way, and they knew they had the mainstream media who were going to provide cover for them and report the story the way they wanted. And that's exactly how it was going. When you read that story by Stephanie Strom in the New York Times, the reporter I later started working for as a confidential source, it was all about how Rathke was going out, how it was his brother's fault for the embezzlement, and how this new team, headed by Bertha Lewis, was coming in and cleaning house. And that wasn't true. They were really covering their tracks. That gave them time to get their paperwork in order to make sure the organizations appeared to be separate. ACORN is not just one organization. It was over 300 organizations that all worked together simultaneously. So when we fast forward to 2011, what is ACORN doing now? What is the activist left up to with ACORN? It's the same things. I wrote an article called ACORN Zombies, Obama and Stealth Socialism. It's up at emergingcorruption.com right now. And it talks about some of this. The group that planned this, these are long-range planners. This started in the 60s. I remember sitting in a meeting and they called it a once-in-a-generation opportunity. They knew that they only had one shot to push through what they considered to be their radical agenda, or as I like to call it, ACORN socialist wish list. And that included cap and trade, universal health care, the Employee Free Choice Act, forced unionism. These were all the things that they had put together in their people's platform dating back to the 70s. And they knew they only had one shot. They had tried this in the 90s with Clinton, but Clinton was a little bit smarter than Obama. When they tried to push through Hillary Care and there was all this blowback, he moved to the center and he stayed there for the rest of his presidency. So when Hillary Clinton ran in 2008, she wasn't going to get that nomination, because I remember we have documents dating back to 2006 where SEIU and ACORN are saying Obama in 08. It was always Obama in 08. They couldn't afford to have another Clinton in office that might turncoat and go center when times got rough. And as you've seen, Obama has moved full steam ahead. Even with health care, even with the judges ruling certain parts unconstitutional, he's still moving full steam ahead. And that's exactly what they wanted. The left has not stopped. ACORN has not stopped. They have rebranded and renamed themselves, and they're doing the same things. The country has awoken, and they're starting to get out there and fight voter fraud. There are over 5 states right now that have some type of voter ID legislation that's pending in their state houses. And you know what's going on? ACORN and Project Vote, Obama's own employee, Project Vote, is still out there doing the same things. They're putting up these blogs on their Voting Matters blog that talks about voter ID being unnecessary and being racist. They're getting these panels together with the ACLU and Planned Parenthood and Emily's List, and they're going around to the states and testifying against these voter ID bills because they don't want them to pass. They cannot afford to have people scrutinizing the election. They don't want free and fair elections, so they're doing the same things. Project Vote, a few years back, sponsored a book, a handbook called The Myth of Voter Fraud. It's by Lorraine Midnight. That pamphlet is now a book. It is out this year, and she is going to be in New York this month talking about the myth of voter fraud. They say voter fraud doesn't exist. It's something that is made up in the mind of Republicans to disenfranchise minorities. When in fact, the reason why it's so hard to prosecute voter fraud is 2 things. Mostly the penalties are not harsh enough. If you get a slap on the wrist or 6 months probation, or like Annie Busfink, who was tried in Nevada and admitted guilt, probation. It's not worth prosecuting. An attorney general has found it to be politically unfavorable. So they won't spend the money and put their necks on the line just for this person to get off with 6 months probation. States like Texas are out there right now trying to change the penalties and make it harder for people who commit voter fraud to just get off that easy. But what we're seeing now is that the activist left has not stopped. They've just simply gone underground. They cannot operate under the scrutiny of the public. So when you see these new groups like Houston Votes in Texas and America Votes all across the country, these groups have reformed, reorganized, but they're still part of the same folks that organized ACORN and Project Vote. They've been working on this for over 40 years, and they're not going anywhere. And they will try to silence, criticize, and ostracize their critics. They've done it to me, they've done it to Matthew. Whoever's out there who's speaking out, they will try to silence them. So that's why we must work together and support the states that are out there fighting against this. And thank you guys for coming out, and I appreciate your time.